Pretend Play is rich with opportunity for math exploration. My name is Jennifer Kotler, and I'm the Vice President of Educational Research and Evaluation here at Sesame Workshop. I've been involved in the STEM project through initial material research, and I also tested content with educators for this course. I was kind of a diva preschooler. Apparently, I did a one-woman show of Caps for Sale, and I performed it for the whole school. I liked acting and singing. I was very dramatic and quite a character when I was little. I think math has a reputation for being boring and dry, and language is considered more social or interesting. But what if we build on the fact that math is part of our language and social interactions? Pretend Play and Math Examples. We lived in the Bronx and we traveled to Long Island a lot, and we always went through a lot of toll booths. So in my apartment building, there were these long hallways that set up a great scenario for playing toll. It was always about how much money the toll was, and over time it got more elaborate, so the farther you were going, the more you'd have to pay, and if the roads were bad, you would get a discount. It was about bartering and bargaining how much you'd have to pay for the toll. Creating math moments. There are so many opportunities for math that can be highlighted during pretend play situations. In this unit, we will explore a three-step process for integrating math into pretend play. The first thing to do is observe what kids are already doing, what themes they're interested in, what their play patterns are like, or how they're communicating with others in planning, and what materials they're using. Secondly, you can find the math in those moments by thinking of where your kids are, what concepts they might need more help with, and what feels natural in the context of what's happening. You don't have to cover every math concept at once. The last step is prioritizing and deciding how you want to guide the play to make math moments pop. As you go through this process, remember, there are also ways to advance students' play without interrupting. For example, say like your students are playing restaurant. You could introduce the idea that maybe the restaurant got bigger. You can guide them through adding more chairs for more customers. Or you could pretend to be a picky customer who'll only eat foods in the shape of circles. I think going with the funny and the interesting can be a good idea. Make believe and math, natural play partners. The research is clear that guided play helps children learn, but it doesn't have to be something that's stressful. And you know, I think math has a reputation of being intimidating, and if it's intimidating, it has no place in a preschool environment. Math can be silly and it can be fun, and that's important.